Let's all play What's My Line? And now let's meet this week's What's My Line panel. First, Little Boy Blue, come blow your horn. The sheep's in the meadow, and here comes the corn. Soupy sails!
Oh, thank you. I don't think so. Oh, thank you, Johnny Olson, for that introduction. But right now, to start off the week, it gives me a great pleasure to introduce you one of the star reporters for ABC Eyewitness News and also an authority on football. Would you please welcome Melba Toliver?
I can see I'm going to have a very nice week here, sitting next to Soupy Sales and another incredibly handsome man.
Thank you.
Jack Cassidy.
My darling, great taste. My pleasure to introduce a lady whose talent, beauty, and wardrobe is only dwarfed by me and mine. Lovely Arlene Frank.
Dwarf. All right, everybody, let's hear it for Wally Bruner.
Thank you, Arlene, and welcome everyone to What's My Line. You know, I think you get the wrong impression here. Jack Cassidy, when he is on the panel, appears to be a very, very conceited man. And I just want everyone to know that he really is. No, he's a delightful fellow.
We'll goose that laugh up, Wally.
No one even thought it was funny, but I want to do something now. I want to cover all of your very attractive faces with your blindfolds.
So soon.
So blindfolds in place, please.
Is that yours or mine?
Oh, I think it's yours, dear. Mine has King's Men on it.
Blindfolds in place. Will our first challenger enter and sign in, please?
Seems no. Problem is,
Mr. X. All right, panel, all of you, I think, are familiar with our guest by both name and face. Therefore, the blindfolds and the designation of Mr. X. Although Mr. X has long been internationally famous in his field, he has, within recent years, become associated with a product. And now let's show the audience what his product is. So our famous guest is indeed associated with the product, and we'll begin with Melba Toliver.
Mr. X, is your product a food?
No.
One down, Jack.
Would it indeed help us to know, Mr. X, your former occupation before you associated yourself with the product?
Well, I would say that they're related, Jack, so even at this time.
Is it a product that is consumed or used in the home?
You mean like something that is edible?
No.
When you say consumed.
Forgive me. No, I didn't mean orally consumed. Is it something that is used in the home?
Well, sometimes.
Can be.
Is it a product that you have physically identified yourself with in commercials?
Sometimes.
I'm really so hot on this trail, I can't tell you.
Go, Jack.
Would it have something to do with the sports world of in some way?
No.
Two down, Arlene.
Is it in any way associated with the world of fashion?
Yes.
Is it something that does indeed come in contact with the body?
Yes.
Is it something other than clothing?
Yes.
Is it, is it hard rather than, soft or pliable?
No.
Three down, Soupy.
This is something that comes in contact with the body. Would it be some kind of, like, could it be in the line, like, aftershave and colognes and things like that?
No.
Four down, Melba.
Is it something that's used by both men and women?
I would say generally not.
No.
Five down, Jack.
Would it be in the cosmetic world?
Yes.
In the broad term. Mm.
Well, that's generally who uses it, but... except a few of us devils who like to look good all the time. In the broadest sense, does it indeed benefit one's appearance after one has applied it or used it?
Hopefully.
Yes.
We must find that little number out. Well, can I take a stab? Is it lipstick?
No.
No, six down, Arlene.
Is it something that comes in contact with a body from the neck up?
Yes.
Does it in any way cover the head?
Yes.
Do you have a guess? Our time
is up. They're wedding veils.
Wigs.
It is. It's wigs. And our guest is Kenneth.
Oh! Oh. I was so close.
Jack, I was just waiting to ask if this is a product that you could use, and I wouldn't have known how to answer your question.
You could have answered it yes.
You wouldn't. But Kenneth Battelle is the internationally famous hairstylist, better known simply as Kenneth. And today he also has his own cosmetic business and is now designing wigs. And I know you made custom wigs for your customers for many years, but how did you happen to get into the mass market of wigs?
Well, I think that when we started making wigs of acrylic fiber, and especially this fiber that these are made out of, which is Allura, it's an American acrylic fiber, and terrific, looks just like hair. But when it started, and of course wigs were reduced in price, it made sense to go mass. If you were selling real hair wigs today in stores, it would be, I suppose, a minimum of $600 or $700, and you don't have many customers for that.
No, I wouldn't think so.
Rather go hairless.
Well, why do you think wigs have become so popular?
Well, I think they solve a lot of people's hair problems, fine hair, thin hair, extra curly hair, too straight hair. Also, I think they give people an instant fashion when they can't always get it themselves.
Well, now, how many different fashions or styles do you have in your line?
At the moment, 14.
So that's a pretty good variety, isn't it? Well, so we can have a look at some of those 14 styles, Kenneth has arranged a wig fashion show for us. So, Kenneth, the stage is yours.
Thank you. Jack, it certainly is a start.
She forgot to bring my brush out, so I'm not going to brush it. It doesn't matter. This is a wig where we actually use her own hairline. That's become very popular because wigs in the past have always had to have wigs. This is Pamela Huntington, and she was nice enough to model for us today, but she forgot my brush. Thank you, Pamela. Thank you. This is Daphne Smith, and this is very long hair, which you can actually brush through. And again, until Allura Fiber, you couldn't make a long hair wig. They didn't work. They snarled and tangled and swelled up. But this you get a small, real head look with. Thank you, Daphne. This is Gabriella. And I promise you, this is not a fright wig. I did this primarily to show you that this was the same wig our first girl, Pamela, had on, but it's been curled. And again, Allura is the first fiber that you can actually set and make curl out of, and I think that's terrific. Also, this is really just a fun thing. It's a fantasy wig. We don't expect people are going to go to the supermarket in it. Thank you, Gabriella.
Sam Jaffe's getting away with it. Yeah.
This is Judith Pemberton, and this is actually what we call a half wig. It's only on the back part of the head, and it's like a wiglet or a hairpiece. And it's a very quick way to get a fast look. If it's a rainy day or you live in a humid climate or you're away in the Caribbean, you can quickly stick this on the back of your head and you have a look. Add a poppy and you're all set. Thank you, Judith. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Kenneth. Now, do you also go to the house and style the wigs when the ladies buy Kenneth wigs?
For money.
For money, you would do it, but not part of the service. Well, right. We're delighted to see your new fashions. And thank you so much for joining us on What's My Line.
Pleasure.
You say goodbye to me.
Oh,
okay.
What's My Line will continue right after this word.
Thank you, Johnny Olson. You were brilliant with our first challenger panel, so now let's meet another. Will you enter and sign in, please? Barbara Williard.
Isn't that an eye?
And Mrs. Williard, where are you from?
Yeah. I'm from Clingerstown, in the heart of the Pennsylvania Dutch country.
All right, Clingerstown, PA. And panel Barbara Williard is concerned with a new frozen product. Let's show the audience what the new frozen product is. So it's a new frozen product you're after, and we'll begin with Soupy Sales.
Thank you. And Miss Williard, I have an idea. It's yeast and shoe polish so that you can, when you get up in the morning, you can rise and shine.
I hope not.
Oh, no? Okay, no. Is this something that is, when it's unfrozen, would it be a liquid?
No.
One down, Melba.
Then can we assume that if it's unfrozen, it's still a solid?
Right, yes.
Is this something that is to be eaten? I have to think about it.
Yes.
No, you wear it.
it could be something, a new frozen product, right? Is it something that would be considered part of a meal rather than, say, the dessert, part of the main part of a meal, the main
yes.
course? Is it... considered in the family of pasta, say?
No.
Two down. Jack.
Was it formerly in, or is it in the meat family?
Partly.
Partly.
Let me say that it is a...
A combination.
It's a byproduct.
It's a byproduct, yeah. Well, has it ever been frozen before in commercial sense?
No.
It has never been.
Three down, Arlene.
Certainly a fast no.
Is it anything in the sausage family?
No.
Four down, Soupy.
You say it does have meat?
No, we did not say that. The question was meat family, and it is not meat itself.
It's not meat itself.
Well, actually,
it's a
combination.
Yes, but it's going to be impossible for them at that point. So it may have some meat, but it's a combination.
That's right. If you can't make both ends meat, make one of them vegetable.
Right.
I don't know. This product, can I hold it in one hand?
Yes.
When it's thawed out, would I put mustard or ketchup on it?
Oh, no.
Well, you might, now Soupy might use ketchup.
He's leading you down the garden path, Soup.
I know that. When it was thawed out, would you drink a bottle of pop with it?
I don't think I would. I'm gonna flip all the cards.
I think I've got it.
All right.
It's a pie.
No, it's an omelet.
Oh, well.
Oh, frozen omelet.
Do you eat ketchup with omelets, Susan?
Yes, I do.
You do. I thought you did. All right. So Mrs. Barbara Williard is Director of Research and Development for Spread Eagle Farm Foods Incorporated, which she runs with her husband. And she has created a new product called Frozen Omelets, and the label is Fresh and Ready Omelets. And you have it right here.
Yeah. That's right.
We don't want to forget to show them that. Now, that's the way it's packaged in the grocery store, right?
That's right. Mm-hmm.
Now, what's the unique thing about this, Barbara?
Spread Eagle Farms is Pennsylvania's largest egg producer. And right now we have about 500,000 laying hens. And
500,000?
That's right. And they lay about 3 million, close to 3 million eggs a week. And of course, these 3 million eggs a week produce 1 million fresh and ready omelets for the consumers of America.
Wow.
Well, it's obvious to me why you went into the omelet business for 3 million eggs a week.
All through the Spread Eagle farm, you can hear the cry that goes up all at one time by all these chickens.
Well, I'll tell you, Soupy, we have the fellow that gathers the eggs in the morning. He goes down the aisles of the chicken houses and he says, "Girls, what will it be today, soup or eggs?"
Where can we buy these omelets, Barbara? At grocery stores everywhere now?
Yes. All over the United States, you will find these omelets in the frozen food cabinets of your favorite grocery stores.
And how many varieties? 9 or 10?
We have 9 varieties. We have a pepperoni pizza, a chicken liver omelet. We have a Western omelet, a ham omelet, bacon omelet, mushroom, cheese.
And we have a few eggs left over, just in case you have any suggestions. Right? But Barbara, thank you so much. It was a pleasure meeting you.
Thank you.
Thank you, Johnny Olson. And now, panel, we've reached that very special part of What's My Line, so blindfolds in place, please.
My blindfold.
Blindfolds in place.
There you are, darling.
There we go. Melba, are you all set?
I'm all set, Warren.
All right. So, mystery celebrity, will you enter and sign in, please?
Someone can read it.
All right, panel, as you know, it will be one question at a time. I'll give you 2 minutes to try and establish the identity of our mystery guest, and we'll begin the questioning with Jack Cassidy.
Mystery guest, would we know you best from your radio appearances?
No.
Arlene.
Sorry, I didn't hear the answer.
No.
How about television? Are you known best for television?
Yes, I certainly hope so.
Soupy.
Is that because you have a show of your own?
Quite.
Melba.
You have a show of your own. Are you, known best for your musical work, your singing?
I wish you wouldn't laugh like that. No.
Jack.
Have you recently retired?
No, and I don't intend to.
Arlene.
Are you, it's your own show. Does it have anything to do with the news?
No.
Soupy.
Is it a comedy show?
Not intentionally.
Melba, that is not the category.
I don't believe that. Are you considered more of a character type, as opposed to, say, a romantic?
You mean rather than a lover?
Yes.
I should hate to answer.
Oh, please do.
I doubt if either categories apply. Oh. Jack.
He's not neither a lover nor
at least not in the type. At least not in the program that he is known for.
I have one. Have we ever danced together?
Yes, and how soon you forget.
I know who it is.
Who tis it?
It's a gentleman who is, he's so rich, and he's so giving. He just gives everything away.
Go ahead.
He's the man who for years has, it's Gabriel Heater.
It's Monty Hall.
Yes. You, Soupy.
Really dance together?
I love the way Jack and I have danced together, but I'm not going to tell where. But Soupy, you didn't get me. My old neighbor and
That's
friend.
That's right. We played football. He once, we played football all
Touch
the time.
Touch football on the same street. We lived on the same street for years.
Oh, boy. Well, were you doing Let's Make a Deal when you lived next door to Soupy?
I've been doing it all my life, I think.
No, Monty was doing, he was producing First Impressions.
First Impressions. And I
was there when the day where he said, I've got an idea for a new show. And I said, how's it work? And he says, well, he says, if I had 50 cents and you said, would you give me your wallet for 50 cents?
Anyway, it was Let's Make a Deal.
It was Let's Make a Deal. And
what
the rest is showbiz history.
Whatever happened to that show? Whatever happened to me?
What else is happening besides Let's Make a Deal? Which is only 300 shows a year.
300 shows a year, but I do get time to play Vegas, and I'm doing an hour variety special for ABC coming up, and running around the country, singing, dancing, laughing, talking, enjoying.
And romanticizing?
Well, I'll get over there in just a moment. I'll prove you wrong yet.
All right, I'm going to let you go right now, and I'll say, Monty, thank you so much. We do.
Thank you.
Monty Hall. What's My Line? We'll continue right after this word. And I hope you'll join us again tomorrow for more fun on What's My Line.
Rob, hosting a game show is just like hosting a party.
Hosting a party?
Yeah, you just have fun with it.
Have fun with it.
Mm-hmm.
Big energy, big smile, big heart.
Energy, smile, heart.
And have fun with it.
Have fun with it.
All right, the most important thing to remember.
Just have fun with it.
You're a natural. Rob Belushi hosts Get a Clue. Weekdays at 4, starting Monday, January 6th. Only on Game Show Network.
Only on Game Show Network.
Not that much fun.